Our guests today pointed out what they saw as some of the hits and misses from this year's short session at the North Carolina General Assembly. The investment in salary increases for teachers and, as you heard, for principals was certainly welcome. The legislature also avoided some truly terrible ideas like arming teachers. But questions do remain. Why weren't there any meaningful new increases in textbook funding or classroom supplies with such a large budget surplus available to invest? Why, with $8 billion in school building needs statewide, did the General Assembly refuse to allow voters to even consider a $1.9 billion school bond this November? But one of the more puzzling moves was the $5 million cut at the Department of Public Instruction. Despite appeals from both the Republican-led State Board of Education and Republican State Superintendent Mark Johnson, the General Assembly moved ahead with the cuts that triggered layoffs and job eliminations that fell almost exclusively on the department's educator support services. Now, this is a group that works with our state's most challenged, low-performing schools and largely rural school districts across North Carolina. You might ask if this was a poorly run or ineffective group. Actually, quite the opposite. Widely respected education researcher Dr. Gary Henry from Vanderbilt studied it and called the group's school turnaround work among the most ambitious in the nation with significant positive effects on students, the likes of which he had not seen with other states. These cuts will fall on our state's lowest performing schools in some of the poorest communities in our state. Gutting this effort simply makes no sense. That's it for this week's show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week with a brand new show.